everyone, I am Nikita and I welcome you all to my channel Flavors from Nikki's Kitchen. I wish you a very happy Gudi Padwa and a happy new year. So in today's episode, I am sharing the recipe of mango basundi for all the sweet lovers. This recipe is very easy to make and it tastes really heavenly. Now let's take a look at the recipe.
Subscribe to Flavors from Nikki's Kitchen and hit the bell icon to receive all the updates of my new recipes. And also follow us on Instagram and Facebook.
Well, now let's begin with the recipe. So here I've taken 1 liter of full cream milk. So this milk is at room temperature. Now we need to boil the milk. So make sure you do not boil the milk directly on the high flame. Otherwise you're going to end up by burning the milk from the bottom. The milk has now started boiling. So now let's check it out. And you would notice a thin layer of the cream have started settling on the top layer of this milk. Okay, so this is done. So now let's add 1 cup of condensed milk to this milk. So this condensed milk gives a really great flavor to this recipe. Do try it out. And now we need to stir this mixture continuously till it starts to get thick. Well, as we have added condensed milk to this milk, so condensed milk always contains sugar. So if you want to add sugar to this, I mean if you are really a big fan of sweet, so at this point you can add about 5 to 6 teaspoon of powdered sugar. And now it has been another 7 minutes and you would notice its consistency has started to be nice thick. Okay, so now at this stage, I am going to add about 3 tablespoons of chopped almonds and cashew nuts. And followed by about 1 teaspoon of green cardamom powder. So this powder adds a really great flavor to this recipe. Do try it out. And just give it a mix. And now we need to keep on stirring and stirring in between. Make sure that if you don't stir it properly, the milk is going to get spoiled for sure. So this mixture would take another 15 to 20 minutes to get thick. Okay, so now one more flavoring I'm going to add to this recipe is few strands of saffron. So this gives a very good color, I mean a very good natural color, and it also gives us a good flavor. So we are not going to add any artificial food coloring for this recipe. Okay. So at this time I'm going to add a few strands of kesar or saffron. So adding saffron to this recipe was a really nice idea. So you would notice that it has started changing its color. It's smelling so good. Okay, so now it has been 10 minutes and you would notice the level of the milk has gone down. It means the milk is getting more thicker and thicker. Well, I don't like my basundi to be more thick like rabdi or something. So this is the proper consistency according to my preference. But if you want it more thick, so you can cook it more for another 5 to 10 minutes. So when I'm going to switch off the flame, it's going to be more thick. So now let's cook this for another 1 minute or so and then I'm going to switch off the flame. So now we need to wait till the milk gets cooled down completely. So make sure you do not add the mango pulp to the milk directly because it might spoil the milk out. Okay, so now let's wait till the milk gets cooled down. And our basundi has now cooled down. Okay, so now to this let's add the mango pulp. And let's mix it nicely. Okay, so we are done with this. So now it's time to serve. So if you guys like this recipe, do give this recipe a try. Also like, comment, share and subscribe. So see you next time. Till then, enjoy!